Hello everyone, I'm Neo Connoisseur, and oh my gosh, the MLP trailer for the movie, the MLP movie 2017 trailer came out literally like an hour ago, and people are already going nuts over it, so I wanted to do a quick reaction and a quick thoughts to it. I haven't watched it. I was actually editing my Discordant Harmony review, but this came on and I just had to do this, so this is just the quick, sloppy, but I gotta get it out there review. Oh my gosh, okay, I'm pressing play. And 3, 2, 1, go. Oh my gosh. Okay.
Princess Twilight Sparkle,
The animation
you
is
made your
so
way
freaking
home from
smooth.
Equestria.
And Canterlot looks
Inspired by
really huge,
legend
and there's
and
Trixie.
music.
Canterlot
And
looks
most
huge.
importantly, friendship.
The animation is
Our
so
blend is
smooth.
perfect.
Okay.
What could possibly go wrong?
Oh, don't say what could possibly go wrong. Gosh darn it, what happens? It's an evil storm cloud and a blimp. Yay, it's a blimp of technology, because technology is evil. Oh no, it kills that dog balloon. What a murderer.
About we
Oh, look.
start with your complete and total surrender.
So it's evil fighting villain that's dark black, dark purple pony. Oh god, that is
Easiest pie.
wow. Like the voice actors. Oh yeah, of course, sea ponies. Let's do it. Oh, sea ponies. Oh yeah, of course. Thank you, Spike. Great, wonderful. Evil tornado. 3D windmill with 2D ponies. That is interesting. Also, that's a nightmare face. Okay, now it's not a nightmare face. I'm sorry for talking so fast.
I'm the one Tempest wants. We're in this together.
Why does
Show
Tempest
these
want me?
little ponies how it's done.
And
It's the magic.
a Buckaroo
Precious
Griffinish.
flowers of ponies and blue.
Oh my gosh, that's funny. And also, freaking machine gun of cupcakes.
Princess,
Oh, and a rain
don't
boom.
forget.
Of course, they're gonna do a rain boom.
Luckily,
Why wouldn't
I
they?
have amazing friends who are there for me no matter what.
Like this music that they use too.
You have visual on Buttercream?
Visual confirmed. Go for cleanup.
Ha! I do like the facial expression of the evil villain. I like these designs. It's pretty darn good. And even that the cat, like the anthropomorphic cat. Okay, movie's ending. Is that it? Okay, wow, okay. What can I say other than Canterlot has gotten huge? There's really good voice acting, they did a good choice in music, and overall, it looks like it's going to be a fantastically well-done movie with a lot of continuity, and, well, I gotta admit, the plot is pretty cliche. It's just like it's basically taking a Canterlot Wedding equivalent of new villain that we've never seen before enters Equestria and wants to take over, and the main six find a way to stop them. They're expanding that. We're basically, oh wow, Equestria is really in danger, so we have to get a whole nother kingdoms of help, and that kingdom is like some sea kingdom with the sea ponies, or in this case actual like sea horses or whatnot. I have to say that I was getting a little I don't know. I was a little down by seeing Spike as a pufferfish, and even in this movie, the little 1 second clip of him just being a pufferfish and saying, "Oh, like I'm so confused," you can tell he's being used for comic relief, and I hope to God that's only a little bit. It's bound to happen at this point, but I hope that it only happens a little bit. I also forget the name of the anthropomorphic cat, but I keep thinking, oh, Opal exists and Opal's a cat, and we have a human-sized anthropomorphic cat that, design-wise, looks great. And, along with other characters like that pirate-like griffin or whatnot, I forgot what bird, but, nice variety of characters. But when you think about it, why are they making so many different characters and different designs of the main six? Come on, toys. They're gonna be doing this for the toys and for the tickets for the movie. And they are taking the genre of, the show to another level. yes, even in Generation 1 and 2, we've had tropes like this where a new evil comes and, you know, wants to take over. But at least they're probably going to have some form of continuity. Does it seem like the princesses are going to be basically playing a big role in this? Like, you know, basically, does it seem like Celestia, Cadence, and Luna are playing a big role in this? I don't think so. It just doesn't look like it. I didn't even see them in here. Maybe they were like a little bit in the background, but it doesn't seem like they're taking much of a role. It is interesting to see a pony with a broken horn, and you could see that some magic was going on, even though it was broken. I wonder what the backstory for the villain is and why they want to do this. And I will say that the fact that the villains are so obvious is a little bit negative, but in this kid's show that's meant to be a kid's show, it sort of has to be obvious so that they know, oh, we're not supposed to root for these people. Again, trailer, really well done. Love the smooth animation. Loved this whole, you know, world. They're like reimagining all of Equestria. And yeah, we're not going to probably have continuity of the movie and the show, despite there being a short recently with EQG sort of bringing a continuity and at least bringing or bridging a gap between Equestria and the human world. The point is that this is going to be a side adventure, yet at the same time a really big adventure. So not an alternate universe, but just not something that's going to become canon in the show. It's its own world. I pretty much think that I've exhausted myself. I've been stuttering, but please share your thoughts below. It would mean a lot. I would love to just hear anybody's thoughts on their reaction to the trailer and the animation and the plot. Please, you know, comment what you think about my thoughts too. I don't think that everybody hates this cat character. I personally don't want you to think that I have such a hatred. It's just an awkward situation when you think that Opal exists. And, you know, the sea ponies, that's pretty much a nod to the fandom, because anybody who was around for that, or anybody who even knows the whole big, huge thing that came out of the sea pony song, you know, they could have chosen anything. They could have been a continuity to the Breezies, or any other species that the ponies, or at least the main six, could have turned into. But they're choosing sea ponies because that's continuity to past generations, and in a way, a nod, and a notice to us who have been around since Generation 1 or 2. Not me, but people who are older than me who were. I guess that's really, truly it now, so please, stay tuned. Any information on the movie? Well, you know, we know when it's coming out. You know, if there are any other trailers, I might react to it, but this is the big one. So, I'll see you next time.